Hello, welcome to my channel, Renzo here. Today let's paint Jake Gyllenhaal. Hello Saint Lou, hello Eve, hello Nancy. Okay, I'm gonna start using synthetic brushes. Okay. The colors are titanium white, chrome yellow, cameo red, alizarin crimson, cobalt blue, and ivory black. Okay, let's mix a gray color, a dark gray for drawing. Hello, Monique. Hello, Priya. See, how much space for mixing the colors, and around here I'm gonna place the whole head. I'm gonna use a little bit of medium. Okay, now let's see. The first thing, always the center line of the face. Assuming that here's the face, the center line, the line for the eyes, eyebrows, from the eyebrows to the bottom of the chin, here or here. I gotta decide, let's say it's gonna be here. From the eyebrows to the bottom of the chin, I'm gonna find the nose here. Okay. Now, from the nose, an angle to the corner of the eye, to the corner of the other eye. Okay. Stepping back and trying to just visualize the face there. Yeah, I think it's okay. Let's see the overall shape. Let's add some color. I'm gonna mix yellow chrome, alizarin crimson, white, and black. Let's see if this color is okay. It's too yellowish. More alizarin crimson, more white. I think it's okay. Hello, Maggie. Hello, Manuel. Hello, Michael. Pigment. Hello, Joyce. Okay, let's continue. I'm just trying to see the eyes, nose. Okay, let's see. Okay, let's mix a color for the shadows. Just yellow, alizarin crimson, and black and white. Okay, let's see. going to add a little bit of medium. I'm just trying to see the position of the eyes, the nose, and the mouth. Okay, now I'm gonna go back to this color. Mix more paint. Okay, I'm gonna follow the shape of the eyebrow, the nose, all the shadows that I can see on the face are going to help me with the drawing. Looking for a really small, very tiny brush. Okay, I think this one is gonna help. Okay, let's see. Have to step back. I squint in my eyes. Okay. I can tell that this guy is gonna be difficult. Trying to see, I mean, I think that he has like a long nose, one thing to see, a lot of expression on his eyes, and a lot of expression on his mouth. I'm exaggerating this, okay? I'm exaggerating this because I'm just exaggerating that, stepping back and checking out. Okay. Always think about, obviously, the center line of the face, the line for the eyes. You gotta be thinking about that. Sometimes I don't mention that, but definitely I'm thinking about that. Okay, let's see this. I mean, I squint my eyes and I can tell that this eye, I gotta say that that's okay, but this eye is kind of down. Even I don't see too much. When I squint my eye, kind of I see something here, and I can tell that it should be a little bit up. I see him kind of. I'm thinking right now about the proportions. Long nose, big eyes. This eye is a little bigger than this one. Okay, the expression on the mouth. One problem is here, if I don't have this okay, and I make this, let's say, the distance between the eyes a little bit, I make that eyes, I separate them more than they should be, that means that I have to move the nose a little bit down, that means that I have to move the mouth too. I mean, that's why and. Paying a lot of attention to this area always, and basically it's the distance here. Remember here, here, and the tip of the nose, the bottom of the nose, okay? If I got this wrong, I mean, I'm gonna just move this and move this. And definitely I'm gonna move that during the whole process because it's not okay. I didn't have the proportion of the beginning. That's why I spent a little bit of time. Here. And especially this. He has kind of a long nose, and even maybe his eyes are kind of a little bit close together. Okay, I have a problem here. I have to move the brows a little bit down, or I have to move the eyes a little bit up. Okay. Hello, Spartak. Hello, Mervat. Hello, Hyman. Hello, Teresa. Hello, Dennis. Okay. Hello, Cherry. Cherry Robertson. Hello, Dennis. God, in 10 minutes today. Great parties. Thank you. Maji, in this culture, you cannot only make one eye higher than the other, you can make it further in. It's very upsetting. Yes. Okay. You know that, I mean, I find kind of difficult. I'm not so sure right now about the distance from here, here, and here. And I'm trying to exaggerate the eyes a little bit, okay, trying to, let's say, make a like caricature, okay, and that's something that sometimes helped me when I got problems with the lightness or with the proportion, and basically. There is, when you have too much doubt, when I have a lot of doubt about the proportions and I'm not able to see if it's right or wrong, and what I do is I just try to make a caricature. A little bit, okay? A little bit. It's not like I'm gonna make big eyes. No, not like that. Okay, stepping back and trying to see the long of the nose. I mean, the high of the nose is okay. I'm thinking about just the eyebrows. Here, here, and the nose. And I'm squinting my eyes a lot, trying to see this, this, this. Not so sure, not so sure. A little bit darker here. Okay, since I cannot spend more time just doubting what to do, because I mean, we always have so many doubts when it comes to the likeness, because the proportions are kind of easy. If you follow just this, trying to make this align, the mouth, the eyes, the eyebrows, and pay attention to the center line, you're gonna have the proportions okay. Okay, that's not gonna be a problem. But you better be aware and you gotta be checking that all the time. The problem is with the likeness. The likeness is something likeness, it means move those proportions a little bit. In this case, for him, looks like he has this a little bit larger than this area. And looks like he has, his mouth is close to the nose than, and he obviously, because the mouth is close to the nose, he has a big chin here. You can see, I mean, the whole mandible is, I didn't realize about that. Okay. Okay. Well, another thing that I do when I have some doubts, I don't know if you have realized, I don't go really dark. You can see now my portrait is kind of washed out. It's kind of, I have kind of milky colors. I don't have too much contrast. Okay, now I'm gonna draw the eyes. Let's see. Stepping back, I think the position of the eyes are okay now, but I mean, I have to reduce the eyes because you know that the eyes are bigger now. Okay. Okay, now let's reduce the eyes. Okay. Let's see, let's start with this one. Okay, I have reduced a little bit the iris. Okay. I don't know if you have noticed that we have painted this. I know it's not so clear. Okay, I gotta put the highlight. Just to compare, I mean, those highlights just help me to compare. Now the nose. The nose. Okay, let's see. I have the eyes. Let's try to see the distance from here to here. If I make the nose here and I move the mouth here. Okay, that's a long face. Okay. Let's see, it looks like the nose is maybe too long, too large, but it could be because of the shadow. Let me put some shadow here. Okay, let's see. Let me step back. No. I'm gonna soft all of this. Okay, I need to move this. This is not okay. I think I'm gonna keep the eyes, or maybe I'm gonna separate the eyes a little bit. Wow, this guy is difficult. I usually put the proportions, and sometimes I just put the proportion without even, paying hard attention to the image, because that's the canon usual proportions. But in this particular case, what is kind of causing me problems is his nose. And in particular that I feel that he has the eyes kind of, the space between his eyes is no one eye, is less than one eye. Do you know that the distance between one eye, the other eye, is one eye? And that's the thing. Let's reduce the nose. I'm gonna put the nose a little bit up. Let's say here. That means that I gotta move the mouth. Maybe here. I think I'm putting the mouth again where it was at the beginning. Okay, I gotta step back. Now read the comments. Don't reduce the eyes but the nose. Dennis is saying that. A bit higher the nose. Okay. What country are you living? I live in Peru, Lima, Peru, South America. The eyes are a bit too up and maybe too close. Okay. Mary saying the eyes look a little too close together. Okay, let's work a little bit more on the eyes and the nose and the mouth. And after, let's say 10 minutes, if I have to move something, I'm gonna just move it. But I'm gonna make a little bit more of detail to the eyes. I'm gonna keep the eyes in just in this position. I'm not gonna move them. I'm gonna move the nose and the mouth. Now let's add highlight for the nose. Let's see, the highlight is here. Okay. Highlight. Stepping back, I think that's better. Okay, if the highlight is here, I have another highlight here and here. Okay, and for making this part, I'm just thinking about this light, this highlight. I have this highlight here, okay? And I'm measuring that from the highlight to here. If the highlight is wrong, I mean, I'm gonna move maybe the highlight layer a little bit or down. That means I'm gonna move the nose again. But that's what happened all the time. But I have to assume that this highlight is okay. I know that, I mean, it could be okay. Maybe not. But anyway, I mean, we have to just continue. I have to continue painting. It doesn't matter if you're gonna face this situation like me, painting live in front of people, and you see these problems, a problem like this, like proportion or something, there is no way to stop. It's just to continue painting. And like I always say, I see more and able to correct more. Just in this particular painting, I tried to really hard to get this. Okay. I think I got a little close. Okay, let's see. Okay, and stepping back, I have, let's say this is the base of the nose. Now I have this base here, I have the highlight here. The distance from here to here is okay. I'm gonna, let's do this. Okay, this angle is okay. Guys, you have that doubt, I mean the best option is just put your brush on top of the photography or and move it here, and you get this. Just if you get this right, that's perfect. And the same for this distance. Okay, think about the color. Add a little bit of orange. Gonna change. Gonna change my brush. Little bit of blue and yellow. I added more color by adding this. Obviously, this color is a little bit saturated than this one. Okay, now I'm going to add the reddish areas of the face. And after this, I'm gonna start the long process of adjusting these colors. And at the same time, working on the likeness. Continue working on the likeness, okay? What are the reddish areas of the face? Are you tired to hear me say the same? Are you tired to hear me? Saying the same all the time. Okay. Upper and lower eyelid, the nose, the chin, the cheeks. Now let's go back to work on the eyes again. A little bit more detail. Okay. Oh, Jerry saying nose is gonna be straight, hanging there. Highlights looks right. Okay, thank you. Oh, he looks like an opera star. Right, so maybe more squared head. Okay. In proportions, okay. Hello, Nick Senigidi. Okay, let's work on the hair. Let's blend everything just a little bit. Let me pick up my brushes for blending. Okay, here's one. I'm blending at the same time. I use this brush to move things around a little bit, just a little bit, okay? Kind of move at the same time, sometimes kind of erase. Let's say I can move this light a little bit up. Now I see the painting and I can tell that the nose maybe is too large. Yes. Okay. Let's work on the eyes. What else I see? I see the eyes kind of too small right now. Work on the eyes. A little bit of red here to this mixture to work on the upper eyelid. Now let's see the nose. Okay. Nose too long, too long, too large. We're gonna move this nostril up here. Okay, you know what I mean? Maybe not, maybe it's just a shadow. Move this a little bit up. Let's make this a little bit darker. Yeah, I think it's the shadow. I thought the nose was large. I mean, not so sure yet. No 100% sure, but definitely I think right now that the nose is okay. Yeah, I think it's gonna be about the shadows. Okay. Oh, everybody's telling the time here in the comments. Let me see. 2:35. 23:36 in France. Past midnight. Out of nowhere. 5:36 in Boston. 12:36 a.m. in Lebanon. Oh yes. Here is 4:38. Okay, let's continue. Let's see, I mean, they're not, can you see the mouth? No. Okay, I have the nose. I'm mixing with this green because I want to grade down this color for this area. When I get down here, I add more red. Okay, let's see the contour of the face. Okay. I'm gonna make this a little bit darker. Work on the mouth. Okay, let's see. Let's see in the image if I put here the corner of the mouth and I trace a line up, it's gonna be kind of in the middle of the iris, the pupil. I think that's okay. Okay, let's see this shadow here. Okay, I'm gonna change the color and add a little bit of blue here and yellow. Mix yellow and black. A little bit of red, I mean alizarin crimson. Okay, let's see the mouth. Maybe let me see. Okay, let's move the mouth up again. Okay. I need shadow here. Okay.
Okay. Okay. Yes.
I mean, pay attention to the chin. I think the chin was about the shadow. I mean, I added this shadow here and shadow here. I think now it's okay. I didn't move the position. I mean, I just added. I added just the shadow there. I think I got the proportions. I'm gonna move maybe a little bit something up or something down a little bit here and there. But I think I got the proportions. Yes. Okay, I'm gonna add more lights. Let's see, I'm gonna add cadmium. I want this to be a little bit warmer. Not cadmium yellow. Cadmium yellow and white. Let's see. More paint. See, I think working really lightly with the contrast. I need to add something really black, pure black. Just some area, just to try to see the values. It's like having a value scale from white to black. And maybe I could add here. I think here it could be a good option. Use pure black. I need to see this. I need to see a pure black here. Okay. I need to see pure white here. Doesn't look that bright, yes. Okay, let's blend. I've been working with really low contrast, really soft grayish colors, and now I'm gonna just bring life to to his face. Maybe that happens when you are kind of scared because the drawing is not okay. And scare of being ridiculous here in front of you. To be honest, I don't care about you. Yes, of course I care. See, right now I see him like I mean this kind of close, but it's like maybe his little brother. Okay, let's add more color and continue working. Now that I think eyes, nose and mouth are okay. Maybe the eyes should be bigger, but I mean the position, I'm saying about the position of, okay, now it's gonna be about just working the values. And of course, maybe I'm gonna move, I mean, I see mistakes right now, I see some things to correct, but I'm not gonna correct anything yet. I'm gonna work on a little bit of colors in values. You know, values is because of this. I mean, you see, I can have the eyes okay, nose okay, but what if I do this here? I make this really, really, like, round. You see how it change the face? That's value. I add shadow here. And kind of bring a kind of, I see him again in that area. It shouldn't be that brighter. I should make this a little bit darker. This, I mean, you see what I'm trying to say is that first, I'm trying to look the likeness in the proportion of the face and the position of the eyes, the nose and the mouth, okay? Once I got that, I'm trying to find the likeness just by trying to get the values right. You see, with this example here that I did here, is you see how easily we can change the likeness just by changing values. I don't have to change the position, I don't have to move the position of the eyes, the nose, and the mouth to change. Him to change his expression or all of that. I mean, that's why half of the time you gotta pay attention, let's say, to the proportion of the face, the position of the features, and then values. Value and color are together. That means that at the same time that you adding color, you're adding values. Okay. Let me change my brush. I'm gonna add more color here. Okay, let's work on the eyes again. It's in black and blue. Let's work on the eyes. Okay, let's see. Let's see, just a minute. I have here black and white, and this is a light gray. It's gonna get mixed with the skin color. Okay. Now this guy, he has this eye a little bit bigger than the other one. I'll read the comments. Looks like a little fat, yeah? Okay. Seems to me eyes are a bit too high. Okay. The left eye is not on place. Dennis is saying that of at least 5 millimeters. Oh, 5 millimeters is a lot. Okay. The eyebrow on the left side needs to be lower and the left eye needs to be longer. Okay.
Okay.
I think his right eye is a bit drippy. I think he knows. Looks like a fat version of Jake. Okay, let's continue. blend. This should be a little bit darker. Sí.
Sí. ¿Tienes mi tarjeta? No sé. Creo que no lo tengo acá. Creo... Ah, está encima de microondas. No, no, con efectivo, con tarjeta. Está bien con efectivo. Sí.
Sorry that today I'm not explaining too much. I'm just trying to be focused on the painting. And adding more color just little by little because I started just with almost no color, and now I feel that it's kind of really grayish, the face. Okay. Oh, gonna read the comments. Okay, Denmark. Oh. The iris on the left needs to be adjusted. Okay. Not the time for the iris for now. Okay, thank you, Charlie. Will you get him to smile just a little bit more, please? Yes. I'm working a lot in this area. I'm gonna move to the mouth now. Hello, David McDonald. Let's continue working. Mixing Camion Red and Lizard Crimson. No, I use this for the nostrils. Okay, now the mouth. Let's see. Okay, let's see. I have to move here the mouth or not. Maybe I have to reduce the upper lip. let me check out. Okay, this iris have to be, I mean, it's not like round, and it should be darker here on this, the white of the eye. Should be darker. I mean, I'm gonna make it darker. Here. Here should be dark. Dark, dark. Okay. Dark here. I have really, really grayish colors today. I would like to change these colors a lot, but I mean, that's no way for me right now. I mean, that would be add more paint and spend maybe 3-4 more hours just trying to fix, to adjust colors and all of that. I think I'm gonna add in this, for this occasion, a really strong color in the background, just to bring more color to the painting. What do you think, Dennis? I think today blue is a good option. Yes? I mean, in the photo, I mean, the background is blue. Blue is always a good option because obviously the face is kind of orangey and blue is the contrast, the complementary color. If I want to bring more color to the face, my only option is around blue. It could be any blue. Okay, any blue. And at the same time, oh, it could be maybe purple, but purple is a color that maybe I don't know. I mean, let's see. Still need more time because, you know, I'm getting close to the face, but it's like it goes from looking like his younger brother to his older brother to his maybe look, it looks fat, looks slim. Okay, and a bit like that, maybe for the next 3 minutes. I'm blending and I'm moving this light a little bit up, and clean out the brush. Okay, maybe a little bit more here, and I clean out the brush. Okay, I step back, squint my eyes, and think about values. I need to make this darker. I'm thinking maybe the background, it could be a really classic dark background. Let me put pure black here. Okay. Now I need to add more darks. Obviously the brows. Oh, not pure black, okay. What happened is I have a lot of paint here. It's not a lot of paint, but enough just to get mixed with this black. And if I don't add a darker color, I'm not gonna get this really dark. Bit of red to make kind of brown. Okay, now that this is dark, I see that I need to make this darker. Let's see, better, yeah. Okay, I need to do something here. I mean, something is wrong here. Can you see this? Okay, I think now it's okay. Okay. read the comments. Blue is gray background red. Yes, I see the dark red at the start. Yeah, I'm thinking about blue or really a dark red classical. I don't know. Don't let his eyes drop down at the corners too much. Okay? So I'll keep that in mind. Not pure black here. If I make this painting, I mean, if I don't get this painting right, I mean, my daughter, she's gonna be mad because she loves this guy. To make this a little bit darker. Let me see. If I love Michael Pfeiffer more, Michelle Pfeiffer. Oh yes. Yesterday was perfect. Today is not so good. But that happened, yes, I mean, that happened. Let me check out this. Okay, I think, let me see. What time I'm painting? 2 hours. That's okay. Okay. Oh, good night, Eve. Sorry. I think my head is kind of tilted a little bit more than the image. Do you think? I mean, that's a mistake. I gotta just follow this, this and this. I mean, if my face is, it go like that, I mean, I just gotta follow that. There is no reason for me to try to copy the eyes, the angle of the eyes, and let's say the angle of the, it, when I have wrong the angle at the center of the face. Moving the light, the nose a little bit more to the right. Mm-hmm. just thinking that, I mean, I feel like I'm getting close, but at the same time I feel like something is not okay. It's kind of difficult to tell what is not okay. Okay, I'm gonna fix some. Move the light. Yes, I mean. I have to put more shadow here. Let's see, shadow here, more shadow there, here too. Okay. Okay, I have to make this brow a little bit thicker. You know, I feel that I could get there, but I don't know what it is. I don't know what it is. Maybe it's the eyes. Maybe I should separate the eyes a little bit. Maybe it's the long of the nose. So difficult to know what is the mistake. I'm gonna make this a little bit darker. I'm going to use the brush that I use for painting here. I have one here. know what? I think I know what it is that was the problem. I think. But I'm not gonna tell you. really make the background. Let's see if I can create more contrast. Hello, Miriam. Valerie, you overwork a painting too much, it turns marron. Marron? Oh, yeah. Yeah, you're right. Before the background, add more light here. Let's add some dark background. I was thinking blue, but I don't know. Blue. I think a really, really dark, dark background is gonna help to pop up the face. Let's see. A little bit of blue. that, and some cadmium orange, a little bit of cadmium orange. Just a little bit for the hair. Okay, let me see. I don't like the background. Now what?
Okay.
I don't like it. I mean, it's so dark. Oh, I didn't get the effect that I wanted. I wanted just to create more contrast with the face, but I mean, I got all. I think. I don't know, it's just now the look, the hair looks lighter than the background. Okay, I need to change this background. I don't like it. Okay. I didn't use too much paint. I think blue was a good option. Just a minute. I see something here that I need to fix. Wow, that's too much. Okay, I gotta think again about the background. I always, when I think about the background, I always think into, I mean, I have two options for me. Or it's gonna be like invisible, I'm not gonna see the background, it's just gonna be there just to make the face or the portrait to pop up. Or it's gonna be present, like with a strong color to create more contrast. And obviously, since the face is kind of orangey, you use the complementary color. It's, that means that you can use any color around blue, ultramarine blue, copper blue, to the purple side, even it could be kind of to the greenish side, okay? And the other option that would be going with something like let's say kind of similar. I mean, not the complementary color. If you have the, something reddish, you just go with a dark red. If you have something like light blue, let's say a face that is light blue, you go with a darker blue in the background. You don't create contrast. It's just about a value contrast, but it's gonna be kind of the same color, a different value. But obviously, I mean, the idea about adding blue, that's the first thing that I thought, is because I wanted to enhance the colors in the face. Because I feel that the colors in the face are too pale. Okay? And right now, I don't feel that I'm gonna be able to get to that color. And at the time, in the time that I have for finishing the painting, you know that my time is about around 3 hours. Maybe a little bit more sometimes, but definitely to get the colors right, I think that would be maybe 1 more hour to put more and more paint on top of this. Yes, but since we are working in the Patreon account, my Patreon account, with adding glazes, I think this portrait is gonna be a good example to be doing an exercise and to show how some glazes can change this skin color. Okay. Let me think. I'm gonna work on the ear a little bit. Where's my brush? I'm changing my camera setups to see the colors because I realized something that adding almost kind of pure red here, and I don't see that red. I see it like a pale red. No, this kind of close, I think. It was like. Yes, let me see. Let me add some red here. Looks like really reddish, really red, red. Yes, I think so. Let me see. Let me add some of those oranges, orangey colors. When you have a color like this orange, then we realize how grayish our colors are. I mean, you can see that the lights here in the hair is you compare with the orange here, we realize that this is a really grayish lights on the hair. Well, here has a little bit of orange. Okay, Dennis, don't say the color theory at red when it's blue. At red when it's blue? I don't get it. I was speaking about the complementary colors. Let's say the face is kind of orangey, then you add blue, because blue and orange are complementary colors. Valerie, when the ideal pastels, I chose the background to be a medium or darker edges. Same thing for Euros, it balances out the main subject well. Okay? Yeah. Hello, Nikki, thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you. It's almost 3 hours. Okay, I have another work, just phone. Let's see, couple of 10 minutes, ten more minutes. This is cadmium orange. Let me put it here. Okay, I'm not kind of so happy with the likeness. I think that there's something that I'm missing. I don't know what it is. I mean, it could be values. It could be move the mouth a little bit up or down. It's so difficult for me right now to move things around. I mean, move one eye right now for me, that would be just, I don't even know. I mean, sometimes I know for sure that sometimes I move things and I gotta just put them back, and I don't want to do that right now. This was a difficult subject, and I think I'm happy with what with more my effort. At the same time, I'm not so happy because I just wanted to capture something more. It's like, I don't know, I can see in his eyes some expression that I don't see in the painting. Okay, I don't see that, and when I don't know. I mean, at some point, I don't even trust on myself when it's about to retouch something, because I know for sure by experience that when I feel that I'm kind of close to something. And that happened to me so many times before that I make us a correction and it wasn't right. And I gotta go back and forth, back and forth. And sometimes it's just a dead end. I mean, there is no way out. It's like, but I mean, that happens sometimes. We cannot find a way to fix something. But don't give up, okay? Because we gotta try really hard, always. For me, I would like to be here painting maybe 1 more hour, 2 hours. But you know what? I'm hungry. Many years ago, for sure, maybe I would be here for 5-6 hours. When I was a student, I was so stubborn, and when I didn't get what I want, nobody could move me from there. Nobody could take me away from the painting. I didn't care about eat or not eat. I mean, I was just so focused on the painting. And I remember so many times a lot of people told me, okay, you gotta take a rest, let the painting stop, watching the painting, and no, it wasn't an option for me. No, and of course I learned that I needed to take a rest. I feel for moments that I should make his eyes bigger, a little bigger. Or I should move the nose a little bit to the right. About the color, I'm just thinking that I'm gonna use this painting to make an exercise in the Patreon account. I'm gonna add some glazes to this painting. But you know, when you get the likeness just there between your eyes, you cannot think of anything else. We cannot think in color, in nothing. I have learned to try to, control myself and try to go with drawing, proportions, colors, and all of that to the end. Okay, I think that's it. Let me see the comments. Good night, Mervat. Thank you for being here. Perhaps within the highlight on the bridge of the nose. Okay, let me check out that. Maybe the background could change a lot, maybe. Thank you, Nikki. When you yawn, I know you need to rest. Yeah. No, I'm not tired, I'm hungry. Okay. Well, I know that I'm gonna do when it came to apply glazes, I'm gonna add more shadows, definitely. It's because I feel that all the shadow areas should be, all the darker areas should be a little bit darker. And I'm gonna add some greens, some transparent greens to this area. Because it wasn't enough, I added some green. I have even green here, but it wasn't enough. Okay. And then, of course, a little bit of more orange, more red. Let me think, what would be the last things to do? Okay, I'm checking, something should be darker here. Should be darker here. Should be darker here. I put a lot of white in my palette because I was planning to clean out all the background, but I changed my mind at the last minute. Okay, this is helping to bring more life to the eyes. Okay, I gotta go. My stomach is making noises. Okay. We always forget the years. Okay, and I read the comments. Cherry and cookie. You must be smelling food. That's funny. Time for dinner, they have called for you. Okay. The year should be a little bit fire. Oh, yes, maybe. Yeah, you're right. I'm gonna make it grow here. I'm gonna leave it there. I'm gonna go back to the ear with glazes. So sorry guys that you won't see this. You won't see the glazes. You wanna see the glazes? Go to my Patreon account. Okay. I'm gonna read the comments. Bottle ear. What is that? I mean, let me see. The glot verb. I don't know what is that. Bottle ear. Oh, okay, bottle ear. Yes. Ah, yeah. Yes, Dennis. Teresa, hello. Okay. Yeah. You gotta just do it. Just paint it. Okay, thank you, Rob. Thank you, Teresa. Okay, thank you, Dennis. Okay, thank you, all of you guys. Take care. Thank you for being here. See you Thursday. Okay. I'm going to add the glazes, and I'm going to publish this image in my Instagram account after the glazes. Okay, and we're going to do the glazes in Patreon. So you can go now. Leave me alone for a minute, please. Bye, take care. Now that I stepped really back, I don't know what the hell is. I mean, it was copying, I mean, his coat, but it doesn't look like a coat. Okay, I'm gonna leave it just there. Bye, take care, bye.